Welcome back to our channel. In last video, we have seen multi-staging of reciprocating compressor, its necessity, and what is intercooling. And then we have seen one point, it is optimum pressure ratio of for getting maximum work saving. And we have discussed that point, but derivation is pending. So let's complete that part. So this is the consider there is a two-stage compressor. P1 is a suction pressure, P2 is a intermediate pressure, and P3 is the delivery pressure here. Pressure in first compressor, air enters at pressure P1, volume V1, and temperature T1. Then it is compressed up by some process P2N. Then after compression, there is an intercooler here. Okay. Intercooler, and as intercooling is perfect, outlet of intercooler is 2 dash here, and as intercooler is perfect, this T2 dash temperature is equal to T1. That means this process, if we join this, then this two process is the isothermal process. Okay, and now if T3 dash is again having same temperature of that of T1, then if we join T2 dash and T3 dash, then all the states here are of isothermal states. Now after 2 dash state, if air is again compressed low according to process P2N, then outlet will be at at state 3. And then as there is no any clearance volume, then all compressed air is delivered to delivery tank or storage tank. Then total work done here, total work done is equal to work done in this work done, it is work done in low stage compressor first, and work done this work done in high stage compressor. This is the work done in first stage, work done in second stage. If you consider only this part, this is single stage compressor neglecting clearance at entry state is P1 V1. So at entry, pressure and temperature, pressure and volume are P1 V1. So we have this equation for work done in compressor with neglecting clearance. Now if you consider only higher part here, then here entry state is 2 dash, corresponding pressure is P2 dash, corresponding volume is V2 dash, and then according to process P2N compression. So work done in high stage will be n upon n minus 1, and P2 dash V2 dash pressure ratio is P3 by P2 minus 1. Now if you have perfect intercooling, then this P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 dash by as process is isothermal. Okay, then we can take common both these values out, then equation becomes n upon n minus 1 p1 v1 into bracket this pressure ratio plus this pressure ratio minus minus 2 here. Now as we know that if you increase intermediate pressure, then work saving is reduced. If you lower pressure ratio, again work saving is reduced. So work saving is function of intermediate pressure P2 or pressure ratio. So for obtaining maximum pressure ratio, taking derivative of this work done with respect to P2 and equate to 0. So 0 is equal to n upon n minus 1 P1 V1. This are the constants, so taking outside of derivative and derivative of this quantity, pressure ratio in low stage plus derivative of pressure ratio in high stage minus derivative of this constant. So this derivative of constant coming to be 0. Here P1 is constant, so taking outside here 1 upon P1 is to this term, and derivative of only this P2, because P2 is only variable here. Again P3 is constant, delivery pressure is constant, so taking outside derivative of 1 upon P2. So here if you take this on left side and one on right side, then this term is constant, so derivative of P2 root of is in similar way of root of x raised to n. So it is n into x raised to n minus 1, that is n minus 1 upon n d2 raised to n minus 1 upon n minus 1 is equal to minus p3 constant. And now here one upon p2, you can write p2 raised to minus n minus 1, minus n minus 1 is nothing but 1 minus n upon n here. Then again taking here derivative of this p2, again by law x raised to n, it is coming 1 minus n upon n x raised to 1 upon n minus 1 upon 1 minus 1 minus 1. Now here cancelling common term, that is n minus 1 n minus 1 get cancelled, and collecting p2 terms to one side and rest of terms to another side, here we get 1 upon p1 raised to n minus 1 upon n upon this term p3, p3 upon n minus 1 upon n. Here p2 is 1 minus n, sorry, 1 upon n minus 2, and this p2 in denominator p2 raised to 1 upon n. So if it is coming outside, then 1 upon n becomes positive, so 1 upon n plus 1 upon n minus 2. So it is coming here 2 into 1 by n minus 1. Here 1 upon p, writing in this fashion, 1 upon p1 into 1 upon p3, both powers are same, so taking common powers 1 minus n upon n, then is it equal to p3 into p1 into p3 raised to 1 minus n upon n is equal to p2 into 2 into 1 minus 1 by n minus 1. Here it is coming 2 into 1 minus n upon n, then taking this root 1 minus n upon nth root of equation, we get here p2 square is equal to p1 into p3, so p2 is equal to under root p1 p3. It means this pressure ratio p2 by p1 is equal to p2 is under root p1 by p1 into p3. So putting value, we get this pressure ratio in lower stage is equal to under root p3 upon p2. For higher stage, putting here p2 value here, again we getting pressure ratio p3 upon p1 is optimum pressure ratio is p2 optimum upon p1 or p3 upon p2 optimum are same and are equal to p3 upon p1 raised to 1 by 2 at intermediate condition. It is at optimum condition, pressure ratio in low stage, pressure ratio in higher stage is same, and it is equal to root of total pressure ratio. Okay, now this is the optimum pressure ratio value. Putting in work done equation, we'll get optimum work done or maximum work saving. So our equation is n upon n minus 1 p1 v1 p2 by p1 n minus 1 upon n plus this higher pressure ratio. Putting this value, putting p3 by p2, we can write p3 by p2 is equal to p2 by p1 because both pressure ratios are same. Now these two terms are same, taking two common both from both terms, get here 2n n minus 1 p1 v1 into bracket p2 by p1 n minus 1 upon n minus 1. So it is in terms of intermediate pressure ratio. If we have to find out this equation in terms of total pressure ratio, then instead of p2 by p1, we can write p3 by p1 raised to half. So here 2 is coming and p3 by p2. So this is the optimum work done when pressure is intermediate pressure is optimum. Okay, there is one important point. After cooler is simply a heat exchanger which is placed after final compression stage and before storage tank, that is in between final compressor and storage tank there is a heat exchanger, is called as an aftercooler. Okay, this is used when there is a dry air requirement for application or where moisture, entry of moisture is not suitable for that application. In that case, we are using aftercooler. Okay, here as intercooler gives work saving, but here performance of aftercooler is not affecting, or working of intercooler or presence of intercooler say not affecting performance of your system. So by using aftercooler, there is no any work saving. Okay, it is only fulfill dry air requirement at outlet. Okay, if there is a aftercooler is not working properly, then there are chances of moist air to be entering moist air in storage tank. By the time as temperature decreases, this moist air will form some water droplet inside of storage tank or in the line of passage of air, and it will be responsible for corrosion of that pipe, delivery pipe or tank. Also it will be responsible for pressure drop because it provide resistance to compressed air flow. Therefore we have to provide periodic cleaning for proper performance or working of intercooler. So this is all about theory part for reciprocating compressor. From next video we will start some sample numericals on this point. If you like this video, please share this video with your friends and subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.